Okay, welcome to the bucket overview that I did. My son and I made a bucket to go with our chopper. So the first thing with a cartoon droid is converting it to real life. Bucket makes it quite challenging. There was only two series of him of Star Wars Resistance cartoon. And based on that, you kind of have to just pick an image that you want to base it on, majority of the scaling of the model. And then find something in real life. In this instance, we chose the length of the legs to match a standard astromech droid and the diameter of the body. Once we decided on that scale, took some images like these still shots, scaled the droid from that, and then from there went into the process of doing the design work for it. So based on the cartoon images, then we did a full CAD design, which you can see on the left, and the cartoon image on the right for comparison, and figured out how we're going to actually make this guy. Once that was done, a couple of pretty renders just to see how it was going to look in real life, the head detail, and then start the build. But before we do that, I'll give you a walkthrough.
All right. So I thought I'd do a quick video breakdown of Bucket. How he goes together, how I made him, that type of thing. So if we start with something simple, he's mixed material, so 3D printed parts like the dome or the helmet, the eye, this top piece here. This is timber frame, and then there's steel rod running through aluminium spacer tubes, and then timber all the way down for all these main sections. So the body is really just a skeleton. Now the main structural strength is through a timber leg here into an A-frame metal piece into like a gas pipe setup like Mike Center does and a few of the other builders that do their droids. So that's a steel tube through to the center section in the middle, which we'll have a look at in a minute. And then the legs are very hard on Bucket. Took a bit of thinking and trial and error. This is timber section at the top. An aluminium tube distributes the force through, so the cables actually run down inside that tube. And then a timber ankle, and then timber feet. So these are feet. But then this is a 3D printed half moon, which just keyhole slots onto there. PVC tube, some printed end caps. This tube on the outside is just decorative. That's aluminium, but that's a piece of PVC pipe. But there's no structural strength in that. I was going to 3D print this piece, but it just made it really hard and just a lot of printing. So just made it out of timber. It wasn't too hard a shape to make. So some of it's cosmetic, but as far as the structural strength, it's just the A-frame there into the center pipe, and then a piece of steel in the center section down to the ankle, and then two casters in the front, and there's a drive wheel in the back and a caster, or other way around, in the back or something. So same drive system as a standard R unit. But so Bucket's helmet, turning around, does come off. You just wiggle it off. Try to get it off without the rest of his head coming off. Come on, Bucket. Give me a bucket. I've got his head screws off at the moment, so I'm making it a bit harder. Yeah, there we go. So this was printed in four pieces, the ear bell, the front visor, and the back of the helmet. And then I fusion welded those together with PLA. So the whole thing's PLA, and then just lined it with foam and an old t-shirt, I think it was. Bit of foam on there so that it can actually come off and you can wear it if you want to. It's comically large, but that's designed by intent. Give me a sec. Yes, Chopper, you can have some limelight too. So Bucket's head is pretty much just sitting on top of his body. Now, I haven't done a laser Susan setup. This whole headpiece is 3D printed. There's a split line just along here. And there's a switch. And turn the switch on, there's a battery pack in here, just three AA batteries. And this is just old Christmas tree lights, but they light up really well. There's a red LED here. And then these front ones actually run through from inside. You see the back of them in here, just a section of them there, and there's just a couple of screws that hold it together. So that turns off. Simple and easy, means there's no connections up to the head. This is a piece at the front. There's a top piece to print and a bottom piece. So three pieces mainly. The eye's a bit separate. So then you could sand it smoother and get that finish. I just literally put gloss black paint on there and it came up really good. And this is just milk carton with a piece of blue diffuser, but you could use blue LEDs. Again, these are just old Christmas tree lights because they're very low voltage. So it makes the battery last. I used it for a whole day and it didn't run out. This is four pieces for the neck ring, printed in four pieces of dovetails. And then that just lifts up and then exposes. I've got on here two screws front and back, M6 into the Lazy Susan. So then when I want to transport him, I can just take his whole head off. That's just a piece of timber. There's the dovetail joints on the print there in four pieces. So they fit on my CR10. I was going to attach it with magnets, but it just flops around on the top of his head and that's fine. So this is the same setup I have on Chopper, my dome gear. It's just a cheap Lazy Susan, 12 inch diameter or 300 millimeter. And then I have a printed ring gear that goes in there and a pinion. This could be designed a bit differently, but I've got a problem with this one at the moment where it's seized up at Bucket's first convention. Not sure why. Might be the motor, I don't know. So there's the water pipe that runs through, and where it comes from the leg here and bolts onto that, a bit hard to see there, that runs through to the inside. There's like the other side of it there. And with that, I cut a small slot in here so the cables that run down into the leg can feed into there. Because what I can do is take this one bolt out and pull the leg off on both sides. So I can take the legs off if I had to. But he just fits in my car with about 5 millimeters clearance. That is the center pipe. So both legs going through there and joining through that centerpiece of tube. Make both the legs parallel and pinned together. So I just sort of set them both up on the bench, parallel, drilled and pinned it. And then this clamp, there's two pieces of section here that run all the way down inside, down to the bottom to join onto the base at the center leg. Let me turn him around. Ugh, get my bucket underneath. Okay, so front arms. I chose to have one front arm move on bucket. Kids love high fives. This is the front arm that moves. It's just on a servo setup. Underneath here, you can just see it there. Trying to get the light a bit better. And just on a paper clip, so if kids pull it, it'll break. Paper clip, not the servo. The other arm could be activated as well, but it's quite a lot longer. So I avoided that because it'll break. That's all just 3D printed. This is one piece 3D printed. It does fit at an angle for a reason. Chopper has magnets on his front arm. So they disconnect and then they reconnect. Inside here, there's just a magnet connection between the servo linkage, but there wasn't much room on bucket. But there's bearings in there as well, just skateboard bearings, and an 8 millimeter shaft through there, and that's enough to keep it together. Here's little side magnet parts, or these little boxes, whatever they are. There's a hole on the top. There's a locating screw. Where is it? There. Focus. Just under there. So the goes into that hole into the top piece, and then that bottom bit just clicks on top of this ledge, and there's a magnet in there. So it goes into where the hole was, on there, and then just snaps in place, and that's enough to stop it going up and down to come off. This section here in the middle comes apart. It's two pieces 3D printed. There's a split line there. And that's where all his internal electronics and everything is. Again, this frame isn't meant to take structural load, the exoskeleton. It's just meant for the cosmetic bit. All the force goes through, and this body frame pretty much hangs on the body. Okay. Now, this is the, I guess, the cosmetic piece that goes inside his body to hide his innards. So two pieces exactly the same. I was going to magnetize them, but then I just put some screws in top and bottom. So the way they have the inside set up, a little bit hard with the lighting. So there's a piece of timber here, a ring just in here that it goes up against, and same on the top. And that's what the 3D printed part goes up against in there, in that diameter. So Bucket's electronics are pretty straightforward. Motor driver there, Arduino Mega. I'm just running on a FlySky transmitter with a receiver, so it receives everything in, sends it to the motor driver for the feet, which is that one there. It's a 10 amp 30 volt DC motor driver, an L298 motor driver for the top, just a DC converter in the middle. This attachment here is for the front speaker. So I've got a what have I got in there? A DF player mini with all the sounds down here from the Arduino. And that sends through a cable. Oh, let me move some stuff. Cable comes out the front and then into just a small speaker and amplifier, which I've actually got buried behind this front speaker vent, which comes in handy. You could set this up many ways for the drive. Bucket's not that heavy, about 20, 25 kilos. I don't know what that is in pounds, I don't do pounds. But I can lift him up into the car. It's just awkward, but.
So hopefully you found that useful, the information in the video. And what I'll do now is I'll leave you with a bit of a build montage. Lots of images. Hopefully it gives you some insight. Unfortunately, Bucket's not a kind of droid that's easy to 3D print the whole thing. So I decided to go with the mixed materials. So steel, timber, aluminium, 3D printing for cosmetics. Just to see wherever it suited and whatever was going to be the quickest and easiest option to make. So hopefully these photos help you out in your build as you go along.